Hello, my fellow artists, and I'm happy to see you at my channel. And today we're gonna talk about the street perspective. As I told you the last time, this will be the last lesson dedicated to perspective at this module, and we're gonna jump to the next one and we'll talk about the specific characteristics of the color, because we're gonna need it a lot. And for this lesson, we're just gonna do the theory part. So I will explain you a few things and you're gonna make it on your own, because I just wanna concentrate on the technical part and then you can do it on your own, because it's not necessary for me to paint for you, because I will explain you later why. So because there we're gonna have this work later and use it with the other lesson. So, but that will be later. So for now, I just want to start first and refresh your memory on the perspective subject. As we were working on that already, and you kind of probably start understanding that better every time you try to construct your particular part of the architecture building, or build the bridge, or trying to create the 3D illusion on your work. That's what the perspective for. And today what we're gonna do, we're gonna create the illusion of the street going behind your eyeball view. So how to do that to make it look as it's actually happening, and on your 2D picture or your paper, you will construct that looking far, far away landscape, the city landscape. You kind of touched that a little bit when we were working before on landscapes, because that's also something which is you can avoid when you work on any landscape, because you thinking about what's the layers of the particular part of your picture goes farther away, and that's create the perspective angle for you. So you want it or you're not really think about this, but that's how it is. Because if you remember, we had mountains and the mountains were far, farther away. We had actually the composition with the field of flowers, and the flowers were going farther away, and they become smaller and smaller and smaller. So that's how perspective works. So lately we were working on a perspective, first of all, that was the rocks going farther away when we did the waterfall, and we also work on the bridge last time, and I will kind of show and stop on the particular constructing moments of for this work. I think that it's very interesting to know how it works and use it in your artworks, which is gonna make your picture more professional every time you actually kind of think about this and try to build your composition according by that knowledge. Even in the still life, if you remember our still life, the graphic work with the still life, we were kind of trying to make this arrangements, what's in the front, what's farther. We were working before on a few other composition, and even fishes in the ocean and everything connected to that. And so today it's a very hard composition, and I think that you will try and maybe make some sketches for that later and try to create that, or go in a plein air, because now it's a wonderful time of the year where the weather is warm and you can go and enjoy the plein air and find some street which is you're interested. And try to make a sketch on a street and try to actually follow that rules of perspective on your sketch and bring this home. And we will talk about more and about arrangements for your composition. So what I want you to remember when you were working on your composition You remember that we were talking about this wonderful book by the Fields Metzger, and that's about perspective, and I always address you to this book. And I want to show you now for the composition how the lines, which is, remember we were creating our bridge and we used this line, the top, the medium and the bottom one, to create the actually the structure of the our building or our bridge. And here the same, I just remind you how that works. So the farther to horizon your view going and your composition going, the smaller everything become, but it shrinks according by the rules. So it's not just shrinks accidentally as how you think it will, or you make it that way, of course, but it's in nature. You can take a look how it works, and that will help you to create your composition according by the rules. And I also want to show you for the street what kind of type of linear composition perspective we will use. This is the composition which is, you probably see a lot when you look in a road going farther, for instance, or when you see the river going farther, or it's any subject like the railway road. So the same principles are applied here. So everything goes smaller according by the composition perspective. So you, all these lines behind the eyeball view, they will connect to the, in one place they will be all connected. And that's what you have to keep in your mind, that's the all these lines will be connected somewhere far, far away, like over here. And this is the main principle you have to consider when you are gonna make your sketches. So for the inspiration, like I always do, we're gonna look in a few streets, and I prepare for you a few reproductions of the artworks. Of course, I will start from impressionistic view, and this is the picture of Pissarro, Camille Pissarro. And this is just a street, but that street connected to the river, actually. So from one side of this picture, you can see that's the street, and another side, it's a river. So it's basically like two rivers on your picture. One, it's a nice flow of a road, and another one behind the trees, it's a river. So it's not easy to actually construct that composition because it has the very slight turn, but the artist make it just because he wants to make it look like not that boring, like all lines, river and road goes in the same direction. He did that curve on purpose to create a much more beautiful view on this composition. And I want to show you one of the works of one famous Russian artist, Korovin, and he kind of likes the impressionistic approach to his work. This is very pretty composition with the street, and that's actually just right on our subject. The older buildings, they kind of go behind the horizon line, if you can see from one side and another, and it has the street and pedestrian part, and also some carriages and cars going farther, farther away. This is the composition which is more simple, and that's actually created not only street by street, but it's also the line of trees goes farther, farther away. So I try to find for you the different kind of composition, and this is Alfred Sisley, who was also impressionist. And as you know, the impressionists are love to go to the plein air and make their composition right on places where they want to capture in their pictures. So that's called plein air. I really advise you to go there somewhere out and find, like we were working on the bridge, you find your bridge in neighborhood, and now you find your street in neighborhood, and try to make sketches of the street. Just get like a little paper planchette which is attached to the more paper, so it has more support for drawing. Get your pencils with you and eraser, of course, and just go explore. That's gonna help you to find the interesting compositions. And this is, of course, it's very famous. Camille Pissarro work at the Boulevard Montmartre in Paris, France. It's one of my favorite compositions. Look at this interesting composition of the street going far, far away. It's like it's not even enough for you to look to horizon to see how far away the street goes. And this was the times when just movies started to be produced, and everybody were just captivated by how wonderful they can see that on the screens, everything moving, and the diligence, the carriages are going, people are going, horses are with carriages are going somewhere. So the streets of big cities become so alive on a screen. And of course, artists, they like always belong to their times, and they create their pictures for their people who live in the same times with them, and they try to capture that too on their pictures. And most of the pictures of the beginning of the 20th century and end of the 20th century, they were about that beautiful life outside, and they were actually trying to capture this on their pictures, and even on the way how the in cinematography, on our beautiful movies, the same way and same approach was applied to the pictures, that it can be like cut it in the middle. So like, for instance, a carriage with the horse was going passing by the camera, and it's like it stopped right when the half of the horse was already fell off from the screen of which is the camera we're working with. And so, and the same thing with the artists were working on, they were trying to master the same kind of type of composition of the cinematograph that times before cinematograph, not like what kind of now, of course it was different, but that's what they were trying to do. And consider, for instance, the perspective of the bridge, like here, going the same way as the street, for instance. But with the bridge was easier because the bridge was going far away on one side. And as you guys can see in the street, it's totally different. So it's like you have two bridges going to see each other far, far away behind the eyeball view. So that's the hardest composition compared with the bridge to create the street going far, far away, or road or river going far away. It's like creating two perspectives on one bank of the river and another bank of the river, or one side of pedestrian part of the road and another side of pedestrian part of the road. And it doesn't matter if it's going to be the actually trees on one side or the buildings on both sides, like you can see on my examples of the pictures. It still will be the same rules of perspective will apply to that. So that's make this, I guess, the most hardest way to actually compose the picture on your paper, because you have to pay attention to a lot of things. And the reason why we're not gonna paint with me that, because I just want you to explore that and make few sketches. Do you want to send it to me? We can work on that and discuss that. And of course, I want you to capture the streets, which is actually go far, far away. And that will help you to kind of feel that perspective, feel how that goes. Don't just try to put few buildings in and that's it, because that's not going to be something which is going to be captivating and interesting on that composition. Try to create the street which is goes far, far away. And you can actually make a picture. I will allow you to do that too. And you can make a picture and at home try to make a sketch of your picture. So another composition which is I want to show you, that's the composition made at nighttime. And see how beautiful is this? how these lights of the city light up the sky, and see how far away it goes. And of course, this is the composition Camille Pissarro, another artist who loves to work on the cityscapes. And as I said, this was very popular this time because that was the beautiful times when people like to be out, and the artists like to capture their like movies, and that was something which is people interested to buy and actually put in their houses because that was in style. And I also want you to see the composition which is my students did, and this is the street landscape right here. And if you can see, the street goes far away. I like the colors of this picture because it actually feels like some rainy day here, because you can see a lot of reflection on the street, or maybe like a young evening here, but the colors are harmonized really nice here in this picture. So you can tell that that actually has the air in this composition. The reason why I say that you can see how the flow is goes inside, that maybe not that street, not the this street's not going too far away, but you can still see how it goes somewhere there far away, but we just captured the close part of that. Or for instance, this composition actually goes farther, and that has the straight look, so it's can be viewed different point of view. And like I tell you before, I told you before that when you take your point of view, that's what you will get on your picture. Same thing where we were talking about the bridge before. When you look at the bridge and it's straight like this, so not the any rules of perspective apply to that, just only that it's farther, so it's smaller. But if you look at the bridge from this perspective, so then the rules of perspective apply. Same thing as we were working on the our interior perspective of your interior. The wall, the behind wall, usually doesn't experience any perspective deformation. Only walls on the side. Same thing. So now when you were work on your street, just remember what you did when you were working on your interior, because the same rules apply. So this part on the side, they experience changes and deformation. They go farther and they become smaller. Same thing here. And only something which is stay like this, perpendicular to your perspective, will not experience any changes. So the whole composition, of course, contain cars, people, buildings. So it's basically very advanced composition. And the reason why we're not gonna paint together in this composition, because I want you just to concentrate on perspective and do some sketches, and they don't have to be colored too, so you can just do the graphic compositions. So, and then later, maybe later after few modules, we're gonna create that composition as a just a refresh of our memory kind of task, and then we will add to that composition perspective how the actually the composition of cars change in perspective. And we're gonna learn how to do the figure and how to actually create the human being figure and what kind of proportion apply to the figure, so that we can actually do that composition and apply all this perspective rules on that. And that will be the hard kind of composition to do. So I don't want you to give up on drawing just because you're not gonna be able to do it right now. So, but I want you just to continue learning the perspective. Just address yourself to that and try to take that challenge and actually work on this and make few sketches. And as I told you, that we're not gonna finish that together, but you're more than welcome to email me your artwork, or just send it as a message And I also have the Instagram account, which is Art Harness and Monosola with my photography. You can send it through that message. So I just want to show you, before you will start working on your composition, I want to show you exactly what you have to keep in your keep in your mind when you work on that. So when you start, first of all, apply the same rule as when you were working on interior. When you create your street, find a way where the horizon will be, because that's important. So I think that if I will have the horizon somewhere here, use like a 1/3, for instance, of your paper, and that is going to be the eyeball view, will kind of contain all the lines are coming to that point far away than horizon. So for instance, I'm gonna make the old line goes this direction. So if you can see, this is gonna be my street and how far away it goes. But this part, that's gonna be sky for you. So you don't have to continue your picture to there. This is just a point where that lines will connect it. So your horizon will be right there. So, and that's where we're gonna have the last building in here in this tree. Or if you wanna have the pedestrian part, so then you have to show your pedestrian part on one side and on another side. And all these lines will connect in the same spot. Right, so if you have buildings, the buildings will go according by that perspective. And even you can get this perspective a little bit more shrinked by the horizon, so that you can have the decent size of the house here. I recommend you to kind of stop the perspective here and make like a street turn here, for instance, and the roof of the building, and this building can be the corner building. So then you have the roof on this building, and this gonna be one of the buildings. The next building will be here, and one more will be here, and the smaller will be there, and then until the end. So, and here earth can be even trees, so you can start from tree. And this is going to be the bigger one, and then it's going to be the smaller, and remember that they become closer to each other, it's farther they go. So, and the one which is here will be the biggest one, right? So this is how the perspective rules apply. And then the road will have two parts, so that's the moon will go one side and another side. So the cars on this side will go this direction, or are the cars coming will go in this direction, if you don't live in England, of course, or somewhere in Asia. So then you switch the sides, right? So you can have trees on this side and building too. So, but they all has to go to the same point of connection. Or you can have the river there, for instance. So then it's going to be the pedestrian side, and that's going to be the river there. So then you have river going on there. If you don't have houses in real life where you live next to each other, that's okay. That can be too. So you don't have to put them next to each other. You can just have that break between them. That's fine too. So you can, like, for instance, just have this building right here, and here it might be tree, for instance, or one of the stores can be over here. So then you can have the store there, and it can be our outside coffee shop here with the chairs and it might be trees on this side too. So you might have tree here. It can be trees going here on this side too. So, but don't put too many details on your work, because that's going to be hard for you to work on everything in the same time, because the composition will be pretty hard. So, but find something which is goes like really, really far away, as I said to you. So, and that will be important. So I want you just to create few sketches, and as I prefer, of course, if you go outside and create them, and then just save them, and then we're going to use them for your bigger composition later, when we will learn the perspective of the human body and how to put your people on this picture, because you might put some big people on this, and it has to be in perspective too, because the person here can be a little bit taller than here, and they will be in perspective too. Or if it's a kid, to over here it's going to be even smaller. So everything going to be in perspective on your picture. Even if you have the bus station here, the bus station will be the same rules will be applied as the furniture in your interior, for instance. So the bus station on this side, for instance, will be like a piece of furniture. So it's going to experience some perspective shrinkage on that. So, and you can have, for instance, some buildings even higher, because I took like a 2 floors or 3 floors. You can have the high scrubbers here, for instance, if you want. Which is gonna go far, far away. Or you can have the buildings which is gonna be just a different size. Some of them smaller, some of them bigger. Some of them go farther, and you can see some windows here and here. So this is gonna be some other building. So your building can be, or might be some church building there. Some cathedral building. So it can be anything. So it depends on what you're gonna find in your town or your city. And I want you to just go and explore, and encourage you to make more sketches as you will find. Sometimes it can be just a very, very fast sketch. You can also put on your sketch, if you find anybody who you want to put on your picture as a human being, even if you don't know what the proportion are, just kind of mark it like a little tiny figure, like the mark on the restrooms, just like very simple. And then when we will work on that and work how to create the human being body, you can work on that and make it more looks like in the real life. So this is our task for this lesson, and I hope you enjoy, and you will go outside and make few sketches and feel yourself as the real artist, and apply all your rules of perspective you remember, because that will be most important to. Without that, you're not going to be able to make that sketch. And one more time, I just want to remind you that the way how it's gonna go for you. So that's what we're using right now, that a rule of perspective. When the all line connect in a particular spot, somewhere behind your eyeball. And that will help you to create your perspective. Look one more time at your interior design or composition. Maybe I'll listen my lesson again. Look one more time on the lesson with the last composition of the bridge, the theoretical part of that, and please go enjoy and make a few sketches, send it to me, we can talk about this, and leave them, put them in your folder, and keep that folder with your works and put that one there so that when we need it, we can use it. And it's always nice to collect your artworks in a folder, so then you always can come back to that and look at your pictures and just kind of compare how you're kind of building your skills and growing with your skills. So, and that's just a good habit to enjoy what you do and have respect to what you do. For the one of the life hacks, we're gonna make a folder for your pictures. I will show you how to do this very easy from the cardboard and some tape. But our next life hack will dedicate it to the paper, because I want you to use the paper which is will be appropriate for your media and for your task. So, and I will explain you which one goes with which. So that will be our next life hack. And the next module will be dedicated to colors. We're going to talk about cold and warm colors and the colors for the beginning of the day, medium of the day, and the evening. So that would be a very interesting module. Tune up, like my videos, and see you next time. Bye guys.